Good evening. Thank you, Jose, for the opportunity and for inviting us. Building sustainable child-friendly cities. I come from Don Bosco. A few years ago, I was in working in Orissa. We were starting a school. The children would run in the morning into the school campus. And sometimes it was very surprising, even the smallest children, once we expect to be crying and not wanting to come to school, running into the school. And it was really a surprising thing for me, and when we started inquiring. After the school, the children go back. It is one of the smallest town in Orissa, really backward. And when we inquired, after the school, the children get back home and they were forced to rest. After that, back to the tuition and then back to bed. And when we inquired further, we found out there was not enough infrastructure to play in the town. And so the school was having that 15 minutes or half an hour that they were able to enjoy before the class started was a surprising thing for me, because the parents were able to pay the fees, the parents were able to think that they are giving the best of things for their children, but actually they were failing to give them their childhood. So that is where our story begins. We have been in the field for past 100 years, helping the young at risk, and we especially concentrate on those 10% of the children and the young people who come into the cities. Take me seriously if you don't give importance to these young people who come into the cities. We may be making it smart with all our gadgets, with all our technology, but they will make sure that after a few years it will become a dark city, not smart city. So they can be keener revealed. The quotation is a very well said. I'll skip it. And the cities are growing, and the numbers that are coming up, like 50% of the world's population lives in our cities, and we are, I don't know if the modernity that is brought into the cities is really concentrating on the children at all. So we even started talking to the ministry, if you make smart cities, have some consideration for children so that it becomes a smart cities for children. And the number again is threatening, because it's not only because of the type of children, because if you take a particular locality, if that was the case of the story that I told about 10 years ago in a remote place in Orissa, I don't know if we start considering the kind of infrastructure that is available for our children in our cities in Bangalore. And if we take the population of a particular area, what is the infrastructure we are able to provide? That's a big challenge. This is for a better and well-earned member in the society who is looking after children. But we are talking about those children who come on their own into the city. And they are smarter, and they are put into all kinds of trafficking issues, and they carry with them the story of the society, which is changing, which is challenging. And they are lost, some of them are runaways, and most of them bring along with them so many other issues into the city. And the crime rates surely will go up if you don't take care. And Don Bosco YAR Forum has been working for the past several years in looking into the care of these children, and especially in giving them the identity, and that was our challenge. We started working on this child-friendly cities concept in the past 4 or 5 years, and it has been a concept that is talked around the world, and even in India it has been in the PowerPoints and in the discussions. And what we did was, we said we will start, because when we considered, we have been running missing children program, even a portal, 20 years now. When the internet was still in the dial-up mode, we were all already on the technological solution for tracking missing children. And we found that running a nationwide solution for tracking the missing children and connecting them with their parents is not going to solve, because most of them run to the cities. Children, for any problem that they face in the rural areas or in the surroundings of the cities, they always come into the city. And if we concentrate on the city and the children who are coming into the city, if we start taking care of them, that would solve most of the problems. And so we started building this concept, and in this particular platform, we not only the NGOs came into the middle. It is, we put the child in the middle. We said, let the government people come into the platform. We also brought in the NGOs, the children themselves, and the business people who are able to invest on smaller needs which these children need in the slums, slum areas, and in the schools, etc. The right activities, and the public themselves. And the success of this particular places, the four places we have started in the last 2 years, it has been running successfully with minimum of technology and maximum of these people coming in. All that it needed was that the problems of these particular children who are facing in the slums are brought in front of this platform. And they will be able to understand and give some solution. And what we needed was the rights, the need of the children being identified and put up as a standard and then brought to in front of this particular forum which is looking into the care of these children, especially those who are in the slum areas, those who are neglected, those schools which do not have the standards, the basic standards which we all enjoyed when we went to school, like proper drinking water or a playground or whatever was necessary to enjoy their childhood. So that is what we tried doing in these particular cities, and we saw enormous change that was happening. And all that we did was to put up a website and then through set up these standards and connect it from the ground level through an app to the city forum which is looking into this. A small piece of technology which brings in a greater impact and a greater future for the smart cities, and they are able to solve these problems, and these business people or whoever was able to donate these small things for these schools makes children smile. This is not the only solution. The identity becomes a bigger issue. So we started working with the technology, and we came up with an app, and it is already in the testing mode in collaboration with the NGO in Spain called Child PPA. And in that, we found that even in Aadhaar, we are not able to identify the children's identity with the help of the fingerprint, because the children's identity keeps changing, especially with regard to fingerprint. So we came up with a vein pattern by which we are able to improve the quality of identification, and we are in the experimenting program in Delhi as well as in Bangalore, and we found the results quite encouraging, and we are planning to improve it. And also we are bringing in the facial recognition and the GPS in this particular app, and we are finding that with this we will be able to give the proper identity to these runaway children, and we will be able to monitor. And the challenges are, the missing children problem is not going to stop, because as long as family is there, there will be misunderstanding, and the children are going to find their way into the cities, whether it is smart or not smart. And these problems, you need to solve it, unless otherwise some of us take up these issues, it's not, and they have no voice, and they have no, some of them even do not have other identity itself. And the standards of care within the centers that are taking care of these children, this is again becomes a challenge. And the preventive care as well as the aftercare, which we need to help them to accompany them back into the society so that they are able to live a better life, that is again a challenge, and we are looking for technology. So let us pledge to build a sustainable child friendly city and ensure that these technologies, whatever we are experimenting with, will be able to help build a better smart city and a child-friendly city. Thank you.